let's do the lesson on your biscuits are too, they're too big enough for me, my Bo Carter. And my version is a bit of a mix between Bo Carter's version and a version recorded by Roy Bookbinder on his first LP a long, long time ago, somewhere in the early 70s. And I put a bit more swing into it than Bo. And I think that goes for most of recordings by old songs of today. They're more swingy. Okay, so we're in the key of C playing, but I have a capo on the first fret. So here are my E strings. And let's start with the introductions slowly. Have a single string ring, a lick, and a hit there. Then we go to our C chord and move over the third finger to get that sixth string third fret. And I'm muting a little bit with my right hand, especially the second and the fourth beat. That gives you a bit of a swing feel. And here we have a F minor 9 chord, which is a bit the surprise of this song. Bar 4. And I mute that also a little bit, because if you hit the other strings than those that are played, then it sounds a bit weird. Especially that second, that fifth string here. And then back to our C chord. Downward run to a long A chord. To an E chord, so hammer on E7 at the pinky, long A chord. To the D, 7 fret and 8 fret first string. Hammer. Another single string run. And those single string runs, well, they accord with the vocals, so they're easier if you sing them later on. So, and then we start with the verse, which is pretty much the same as what we played before. But I play it slowly and sing also softly. Don't put no more baking powder in your bread, you see. You know your biscuits are tall enough for me. Don't put no more sugar, mama, in your bread, you see. You see the vocal line, something like that. And then we go to a partial F chord, which is a nice, sort of turnaround. Then we have the vocal part also when we go to the E. Some folks call you ugly, you know that it's true. There's only one thing about you, makes me love you like I do. So again. And then we have the instrumental part, which is a repeat of the previous things. And there's just one thing I play as an instrumental. Sorry. So I'm playing the intro as an instrumental part after the verse. And then a little bit with those single string runs. Well, that's about it, I guess. I did an end run, something like, well, at the end I repeated the 24th bar, you could say, and 25th. See, only the 24th bar, I play that three times. You can play a zillion combinations with these first string, 3-5, open, fourth string, first open, and then to the C on the second string, C, A, and both strings open after that, fourth open, up first, and back to the C. Those notes I explained, but in different, well, rhythmic feel, and I'm sure you can find something of yourself. And then we're ending with that C6 chord on the 5th fret. So that's it for your biscuits. Have fun with this tune.